But first tonight, as if the state's health system isn't enough of a mess, it's now being rocked by serious allegations of bullying and harassment.
10 News can reveal it is so widespread and destructive, workers are being driven from their jobs while others suffer from crippling, even life-threatening anxiety.
Bullying is rife in the health department, in hospitals and the ambulance service.
The officers are bullied, intimidated, harassed by managers. And that process seems to be condoned.
For the first time, the health department has revealed it's investigating 232 cases of serious bullying.
There should be no bullying, no violence of anyone working in the health system.
But unions say there are many more instances of serious workplace harassment going unreported.
Look, I think that's an underestimated figure. There's a lot of people who don't come forward. They don't feel confident to be able to raise their hands. And so at the end of the day, what is being investigated could well be the tip of the iceberg.
Nurses report harassment by executives and unit managers who themselves are under pressure from above.
When pressure is on, when deadlines have to be met, when expectations are high, then people sometimes forget the basics of respect and dignity.
They get into people's face, they subtly threaten them. The invasion of personal space and the yelling and abuse at staff members has been rife over the years and still continues.
Health workers aren't just being bullied by their managers and colleagues. Increasingly, the family members of patients are bullying nurses to provide better care. Unions say staff shortages have increased stress levels and that patient care suffers. The government admits there's a problem and says it's acting to improve the workplace culture inside the health department.
It's not to suggest that everything's fixed overnight, but it's certainly moving in the right direction.
John Hill, 10 News.